How is everyone? My names are Mr. David Mwaniki from Kit Technical College. And here with you, I will be teaching you a technical drawing. This one, we shall be learning technical drawing, which is the engineering drawing A1. And I want to show you a couple of things that you need to purchase before we get to start the technical drawing unit. So we have got this. You need to purchase this. These are called set squares. These are set squares. So you need to get to purchase these set squares. They are bought the two of them. Once you go to the bookshop, you'll be able to get the two of them. They are always in pairs. We have also a T square. This is called a T square. This is a T square. You also need to purchase this. And on top of this, you also need to purchase a drawing set. This is a drawing set, and this is the recommended drawing set. So make sure that you get to purchase this one. The other thing that you need to purchase is this one. This is called a masking tape. This one, masking tape. This is a masking tape. So it is usually used to stick your paper onto the drawing table. Then the other thing that you need to purchase is this booklet, which is over here. It is called a drawing book, this one. So, and you can see that inside the drawing book, it is plain. It is written nothing. It has no rules nor squares. So you need to purchase this plain drawing book, this one. So it is a drawing book. So you need to purchase this. You also need to purchase a pair of several types of pencils. I think there's a list that is circulated over the WhatsApp groups, and I think I wrote the specific types of pencils that you need to purchase. So these are the components that you need to have before we start the technical drawing. So we have said you need a drawing book, this one. And you can see that inside the drawing book, it is plain here. We have said you need to purchase a masking tape, this one. And we have said it is usually used for sticking your paper onto the table. The other one is a T square. This one, you need to purchase a T square. We have again said you need to purchase the two types of set squares. So these are set squares. And we have said they are bought in pairs and they should be found in one box from the bookshop or wherever you'll be buying them. We have the engineering drawing set. This one. So again, you also need to purchase a pencil, and there is a specific type of pencil that I wrote onto your WhatsApp group, the HP and the 2H type of pencil, this one. So those are the major things that you need to have before we get to begin the engineering drawing this unit. So make sure that you have them before tomorrow, which is on Tuesday. You also need to have a working space whereby you need to draw your you need to draw where to draw your drawings. And first of all, we'll begin with the course outline. And the course outline or the topics that you need to study under engineering drawing, we have number one, which is the basic plane geometry. So this is the basic plane geometry. And a basic plane geometry you'll be able to study about. We'll study about the introduction, drawing of lines, bisecting of lines, perpendicular lines, parallel lines, dividing lines into parts, drawing diagonal scales, circles and parts of a circle, finding the center of arcs and circles, constructing angles, drawing radii corners of angles. The second topic will be further basic plane geometry. We'll study about the introduction part, triangles, types of triangles, equilaterals, the 3-4-5 right angle triangle, and more other triangles. We'll also study about the right angled triangles and other triangles and circles. We'll also be able to study about types of equilaterals, polygons with more than four sides, regular hexagons and octagons, constructing regular polygons, circles of polygons, constructing regular polygons, line tangents to circles, tangential circles, tangential circles to ellipses, and construction of ellipses. So first of all, we are going to tackle these two topics at a go. Basic plane geometry and the further basic plane geometry. First of all, we'll tackle those ones, then the rest, we'll be tackling them later as we proceed. So make sure that you purchase all those items so that we may run smoothly in our technical drawing. So first of all, I would like to show you how to use these equipment you can see. So first of all, we will be plugging out a paper. Like for example, if this is the paper, so you can see that I've plunked out this paper out of this drawing book. So this paper, it is the one that we'll be using in single, so you'll not be doing your technical drawing or your drawings while inside the whole of this book because of the setting parameters and the rest. So you will be blanking a paper like this from this drawing book, then you use this single paper. So I want to show you how to set your paper into the drawing board. So to set up your paper, this is how you set up your paper. And setting up your paper is very easy. So first of all, you need to have your masking tape near. So let's assume this is your drawing plane. I assume this is your table now. You can see that this table has got, let me select from this point, let me select from here. From here up to here. Let me assume this is my working plane. Okay, I hope you can see clearly. So let me assume this is your working space, this enclosed space. So in this space, this is the space whereby you will set up your paper. So you will take this single paper, the one I've planked out of this book. So you will set up your paper like this. So first of all, you will take your T-square like this. This is your T-square. It is usually used for setting up your paper. You place it like this. So you can see that it is able to move along this working space. So if this is my table, for instance, this one, you can see where I've placed, you can see the head of the T-square, where it is placed. I hope everybody can see. and you can see that it is able to move swiftly from upwards up to downwards, like this. So for instance, you begin with the setting up of the paper, this one. So you will take your paper like this. So you always ensure that it lies on the bottom of this D-square. So you can see that from below, it exactly fits into that, onto the bottom of the T-square exactly. So you can see that my paper exactly lies horizontally onto the bottom of my T-square. You can see the way it is. So that is how you set up the paper. And for instance, you need to have your masking tape. So this is the masking tape. So first of all, you take your masking tape and this is how you do it. You take your masking tape, this one. So this is the masking tape. So you can see the way my paper looks like. So you will take your T-square like this, and using your table or wherever you are located, I think I've told you that you should be having a table and a smooth one. So first of all, you lay up your paper like this, and I've said it should horizontally align up with your paper, so like this. So this is how we set up the paper. So you set up your paper like this. Like that. So that is how you set up your paper. You set it in such a way that from the bottom of the paper, you can see that it is in parallel with my paper. So you can see that the parallel, in fact, should exactly touch my T-square. So you can see where it fits. I hope you can see. So that is how we set up the paper. And these ones are usually used in conjunction with this one. This one, let me show you how. So if you have placed your T-square here, you will be using these ones to bisect a line or to draw a line in perpendicular to this T-square. So you can see that it is able to move swiftly along this T-square like this. So this is used in conjunction with the T-square. So first of all, I've told you that the role of a T D-square is to set up the drawing paper, and we normally use it in conjunction with the set squares, these ones, and you can see that they are able, you can see that the set squares are able to slide over the T-square like this, and also like this. If you want to draw a line which is so you can see that they are able to correlate. So we normally use these ones for that purpose. When you look at your drawing set, this one, it has got several instruments. Everyone can see. So you can see inside we have got several components inside the engineering drawing set. So what you do, you just open it up. You will be able to see a set of dividers. So these are the dividers. And the engineering applications, it's not much different from what you had in high school. It is the same geometrical set you have. It is only that this one has got some strange components you've maybe never seen, but these are the ones that you use. This is a divider, like the one that you used to see, and it has got a pencil on one end. You have another one here, this one, so you just stretch it like this. So these are the major items that we shall be using in technical drawing. So basically what I will be doing is, so first of all, you will get to watch on, you just have to watch this clip that I've recorded so that you may be able to know the kinds of components that you normally use in technical drawing and the applications. That was the major aim of recording the clip. The other thing is, I will be drawing the drawings myself. So I will be setting up the paper, drawing the drawing exactly the way it is. Then from there, you'll be using the same procedure to set up the paper, to draw the same drawing with the same specifications. Then from there, I'll be giving you an outline of all the steps that you need to follow for you to come up with that final drawing that I've come up with. Are we together? So first of all, have all those equipments with you. Get to purchase them in those, they are particularly found in those bookshops, like those who are around Nairobi or wherever you are. You can be able to walk around those big bookshops, or you go to those supermarkets. In fact, in the supermarkets we have a section whereby we have got some stationaries. I think you can be able to find these set squares, or you just inquire for them. You will also be able to find these ones in those bookshops in pair, the way they have displayed them here. Also get to inquire for a masking tape, this one, for sticking your paper. Draw, get also to purchase this book. This is an Edry drawing book. So this is the one that we shall be using. It should be stitched like this. So this is an Edry drawing book. Again, I've said this is the drawing set. It is also available in these bookshops, or you can also go to a supermarket. Once you go to the supermarket, inquire for the section whereby they do sell or they deal with those stationaries. Just inquire for it, and you'll be able to find one. Look for good pencils. We have the HB and we have the 2H. Make sure that you have the two of them. The other thing that you need to have is a rubber. Rubber is very important when it comes to technical drawing. Make sure that you get a good rubber, a Staedtler type of rubber. I think it goes for around 50 bob. That is the best one. It can be able to erase all the traces that are in that paper if you make something wrong. And I don't think whether I have much to say, so that is the introductory part of it when it comes to technical drawing. And finally, before I get to forget, you also need to get to look for a space, a good table. Maybe at home, you can also use the same table you use for some activities there in the house, as long as it is at a rectangular type of a table or a bigger one, such that it is not rough and your T-square is able to slide so well and smoothly without so much rough surfaces on that particular table. So ensure that you look for a good table whereby you can sit alone and make sure that and get to draw these drawings. Look for those equipments kindly and the journey shall be very smooth. Also, when we open up, once we open up physical classes, I will also be able to meet you. Maybe I get to brush over those areas and I get to see some of those areas maybe you wanted to have some physical questions and the rest. That one I will do. The other thing I will be doing after every drawing, I will be giving an assignment. I will be back marking that assignment daily. And technical drawing is appearing daily. If you look at your timetable, make sure that you follow your timetable keenly. It is appearing daily. Follow all my assignments. If I've given you a drawing that you should draw, ensure that you get to draw that particular drawing kindly. Draw it, do the assignment, bring it back, I mark, and give you the marks. Are we together? So, with those few remarks, I will stop there. And I will also insist, get to purchase all those items that I've showed you. That is how they look like. This is how the drawing set looks like, the masking tape and the rest. And I think life will be very smooth. We will learn technical drawing comfortably. And after every topic, I will also be posting a past paper for you to be able to check on it and also be able to solve and take a photo attaching to the online platform. I will be able to mark and submit your marks back. So thank you so much. Let's meet in the real deal.